Hey everyone, today we'll be taking a look at the ExpertCenter PN64 mini PC by ASUS. Specifically, I have with me the PN64-B-S7035MD barebones model, which is powered by Intel's latest 12th generation Core i7-12700H Alder Lake mobile processor. We'll take a look at the specs of this mini PC, do the usual unboxing, and put it all together to run some benchmarks. Let's get started. Starting with the packaging, we see that ASUS has gone for a white and grey colour theme that is a little more serious, unsurprising really, seeing as this product is slightly targeted at office productivity users on the higher end, and you also don't get much else in terms of product descriptions on the packaging. Here's the specs of the PN64-B-S7035MD. ASUS has equipped this particular model with the higher-end Intel Core i7-12700H mobile processor, which has a max turbo frequency of 4.7 GHz. This processor has 14 cores and comes with integrated Intel Iris Xe graphics. RAM support is in the form of two DDR5 SODIMM slots with support for up to 64 GB of RAM and the DDR5 4800 standard. Storage-wise, ASUS has included a single PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slot, as well as a single SATA 3 port for a 2.5-inch SSD or hard disk. For audio, the PN64 comes with Realtek's ALC897 audio built-in, and for internet connectivity, we get 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet powered by Intel's i225V and Wi-Fi 6E connectivity courtesy of Intel's AX211, which also provides support for Bluetooth 5.2. And with that, let's take a look at the contents of the box. Here it is, the PN64 in the flesh. We'll set it aside for the moment to see what ASUS has included in the box. Opening up this section right here, we see that ASUS has included a power cord, and this is accompanied by a 120-watt power brick. We also do get a bunch of multi-language quick start guides, like so. And this is accompanied by a booklet containing safety information, as well as a warranty information leaflet. Documentation aside, we also get a pack of M.2 drive screws and a pack of 2.5-inch drive screws. These are accompanied by a VESA mounting kit for you to mount the PN64 behind a monitor if you like to do so. Interestingly, ASUS has opted to include a DVD driver disc with the PN64, which is kind of surprising seeing as optical drives are fast becoming a thing of the past. Onto the PN64 itself. It has a no-nonsense and functional appearance with a full plastic exterior in black. We get ventilation openings on three sides of the mini PC, like so, with diagonal slats in glossy plastic for some added contrast. There is also a Kensington lock slot opening on this side here. And you'll have noticed this bit here, which is actually a padlock ring that allows you to attach a lock to prevent unauthorized disassembly of the mini PC, which I guess would be more applicable in sensitive business contexts. In terms of front I/O, we get a 3.5mm microphone and speaker combo jack, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, as well as two USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports. While we're still on the front fascia of the PN64, we also get a drive activity indicator LED as well as the power button. As for the rear I/O, the PN64 comes with two HDMI 2.0 ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port that supports power delivery and display output that complies with the DisplayPort 1.4 standard. We also do get another USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, as well as a jack for connecting the power brick of the mini PC. For this particular PN64 model, the B-S7035MD, it comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 port right here. Other models of the PN64 could come with, say, an additional HDMI port, serial port, VGA port, or even a second LAN port instead, as per this illustration from the PN64's user manual. With that, let's have a look at the insides of the mini PC. For storage, the PN64 comes with a single PCIe 4.0x4 M.2 slot, and it's located right here. You'll note too that the Intel AX211 Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module is in the same region as well, being situated here. Over on the other end are the two DDR5 SODIMM slots that can support up to 64GB of RAM and the DDR5 4800 standard. The base plate of the PN64 also doubles up as the mount with which to install a 2.5-inch SATA SSD or hard drive. To get this barebones mini PC up and running, all you'll need are some RAM, a storage drive, and an operating system. Here, I'll be installing two 8GB sticks of Team Group DDR5 4800 RAMs. Following that, I've installed an ASUS ROG Strix SQ7 1TB NVMe SSD, and I'll be getting Windows 11 Pro installed on it. With that, time to reattach the base plate to get a finished product that is ready for a Windows installation. As mentioned earlier on in the video, the PN64 can be mounted on the back of your monitor, provided that your monitor has VESA mounts on the rear. To do so, you'll first need to install these two screws that come included with the packaging. Thereafter, installing the VESA backplate on your monitor is a straightforward affair, like so. Once done, it's a simple matter of sliding the mini PC into place and thereafter securing it with this latch on the base plate. And with Windows 11 installed, the PN64-B-S7035MD is all ready for use. To recap, these are the final specs that I'll be running with this particular PN64. Now, to do a quick test of the computing prowess of this mini PC, I'll be running Cinebench R23 single core and multi-core tests, as well as the 7-zip compression test to get a flavor of its performance with synthetic benchmarks. With that, the approximate temperature of my surroundings is around 29 degrees Celsius, and the idle CPU package temperature for the PN64 is around 39 degrees Celsius on average, with an average idle CPU power draw of 3 watts. Do note that I did not tweak the power limit settings in any way for the benchmarks, and left them as they were out of the box. Starting first with the Cinebench R23 multi-core test, we see that the PN64 gets a score of 10,602 and a score of 1,507 for the single core test, which are pretty respectable scores given that this is an Alder Lake Core i7 part after all. During the multi-core test, the PN64 achieved an average CPU temperature of 72 degrees Celsius once the fans spun up to maximum speed in response to the CPU load. I must say that the fans ran pretty loud during the test, but this is unsurprising really given how intensive a CPU workload the Cinebench test is. Moving on to the 7-zip built-in benchmark, the 12700H processor of the PN64 puts out the scores that you see on the screen, which demonstrate the computing prowess of this mini PC. In conclusion, the ASUS ExpertCenter PN64 mini PC, in the guise of the S7035MD spec that I have here, is a solid workhorse that will do well in business contexts that deal with CPU-intensive tasks such as photo and video editing. In terms of pricing and availability, the S7035MD barebones kit can be had in Singapore for a price of $949. Do note that on top of this sum, you have to purchase your own RAM, storage, and operating system. With that, thank you so much for watching. Do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.